sports world. Many users on Twitter told Republican State Representative Pat Garofalo from Farmington that his comment about the NBA and its players was racist. Well, our Jessica Miles spoke to Garofalo today. So, Jess, what kind of backlash is he facing from this now?
He's seen a lot of it, heard a lot of it. A lot of it has been tweeted back to him. Mm-hmm. He said when he saw his name on ESPN this morning when he was at the gym working out, he knew what he had communicated via Twitter wasn't good, and it didn't reflect well on Minnesota.
All right, I want to get back to this Twitter controversy.
The calls were coming in fast and furious on radio talk shows Monday.
Do I want a representative from my state that looks like this? No. Should you? No.
Exactly.
Pat Garofalo can spin his wheels all he wants. Right now, he comes off as a racist.
A controversial tweet that made national headlines.
Well, first of all, there's no doubt that there's racial undertones to that because he picked out the NBA, which is close to 80% black.
The tweet read, "Let's be honest, 70% of teams in NBA could fold tomorrow. Plus, nobody would notice a difference with possible exception of increase in street crime." He initially stood by his words.
When I started getting criticized for it, I thought about it, and I thought about, that I wouldn't appreciate it if everyone said that all politicians were bad because of one person or a small group of people. So I kind of applied that lesson to myself.
His tweet has resulted in 300 new followers since Sunday night. It's been retweeted more than 1,700 times, and there are countless comments to go with it, most of them unfavorable toward the father of two teenagers who were quick to learn of their dad's faux pas on social media.
I talked about them to learn from dad's mistake and not to make this mistake yourself, and they both get it. And again, I just want to make sure everyone understands that I'm very sorry that it was a mistake, and I'm going to do my best to make sure I don't make that mistake again.
State representative told me today, if you don't fill in the dots, somebody else will, which is why he wanted to get that apology out there to the NBA players and to the owners as well. His kids, by the way, 18 and 15, so they're, of course, on Twitter, they're on Facebook, all of that kind
of
stuff.
Yeah, they're very aware of it. Yeah. How about the Timberwolves, though? What do they have to say about this?
You know, that's interesting. I called the Timberwolves today just to reach out to them and say, you know, what's going on? What's your response to this? And they basically said, you know, we look at the public's reaction to the statement, and we think that speaks for itself. So, and it did.
All right. Yeah. I'm sure we're going to hear more about this, Jess. Thank you.
Yep.
Phil.
Well, around the world tonight, clues that Cruz thought would lead to that missing Malaysian airline.